Hi, welcome back to the Blind LP for Eagle Eye Mysteries in London. We are going to start on the next case, which would be case of the pilfered phone. So let's begin. Say, Stakaze and Jake, hate to bother you, but I'm here at the Old Vic Theatre and our telephones disappeared. Oh, is that so, Nigel? If the phone's gone, then what are you using to call us? You'll have to be more clever than that to fool Stakaze and me. No, Jake, the theatre's phone is still here. But we were using a little portable phone as a prop in our play, and now it's gone. And Askew is sure that someone's stolen it. By the way, would anyone bother? It's ominous, Jake. I think you and Stakaze should come down here right away. If you insist, Nigel, we'll see you at the Old Vic Theatre. No, actually, Gay Goodbow and I are heading to Covent Garden. After you talk to Anna Skew here at the Old Vic, come join us there. Bye. I don't know what voice to give him, but we'll see. Okay, let's go to the Old Vic first. There's an Askew, and boy does she look steamed. Let's ask her about the missing phone. I volunteered to be the property manager for the children's theatre program this summer. That means I take care of all the properties or props used in the place, and Nigel was helping me. For an actor to steal one of the props, why, it's unheard of. Who are the suspects, Miss Askew? In the play Bad Signs, three of the actors pretend to use the phone. Iron Knight, Aaron Charles and Gay Goodbow. Any one of them could have pocketed the phone at the end of the last act. But for what? It's Nigel's job to collect the props after the play is over. He's the one who told me the phone was missing, but perhaps he took it instead. So he's also a suspect. You're suspecting our cousin? The worst part is the phone doesn't belong to the theatre. Emma Finley, an actress here, loaned it to me. It was the real thing, not a cheap plastic toy. Very generous of her. And now I've gone and lost it. Don't worry, Miss Askew. We'll find Emma's phone, no problem. Do you know where Ian? Is it Ian? Ian. Aaron and the other suspects have gone. I think Mr. Tantrum, the drama teacher, has sent them out on assignments. You should ask him where they are. At this time of day, he can usually be found in the common room at the University of London. And do you know where we can find Emma Finley? Drop by the Wax Museum. I think she's working on a costume there. Okay, let's look. Nigel's clipboard holds his check-off list of props for the playback signs. Yeah, all the props are checked off but one, the cellular phone. Oh, there's three places to go to. He asked us to go to Covent Garden, right? There's Nigel. He's people watching here at the Covent Garden Mall with his friends Gay and Dorothea. What voice should I give him? Nigel, we heard you're the one who noticed the cellular phone was missing. Right, I would look all over the stage for it, but it was nowhere to be found. Quite mysterious, really. Did you think of calling the phone from somewhere else? You can listen for it to ring. That way, if it's still in the theatre, you can figure out where it is. That's how my mom finds her cellular phone at home sometimes. What a clever idea, but it won't work with this phone, I'm afraid. We turned off the ringer so it wouldn't buzz during the play. If someone tried to call Emma Finley, that could ruin the performance. They could take out the card. The phone has number stored in it, so you can ring up other people with just a push of a button. We're under strict orders not to do that, though. We just pretend to use the phone in the play. Let's face it, a cellular phone is cool, but it's a dumb thing to steal. Once we tell the phone company it's missing, they'll make sure the phone never works again and it'll be worthless. Somebody must have had a special reason to nick it, if it was stolen at all. During the play, I pretend to use the phone. In the middle of the second act, when the lab catches fire, I use it to ring the fire department. In England, if there's an emergency, you dial 999. In the United States, you dial 911 or 0 to talk to the operator in an emergency. Iron Knight plays a fireman. Is it Iron or Ian? Give me a moment. Let me check. Okay, I'm back. It's pronounced as Ian, so Ian Knight plays a fireman. A fireman. He's really very good. My character is really upset by the fire, but he tells me, "Chin up, old girl, you mustn't give up." Ian uses the phone in the third act, then he sets it down on the table. That's the last anyone saw of it today. I suppose anyone in the play could have picked it up after that. I just got here myself. What's all this about a stolen telephone? It's a real cellular phone, Dorothea, being used as a prop in the summer play. Bad signs. After today's rehearsal, it was missing. We're trying to figure out who took it and why. Well, good luck. I certainly don't think Nigel would have taken it. He spends quite enough time on the phone as it is, ringing round to all his chums. We can't talk long, Starkaze. Nigel and I are going off to see a show. Gay wants to stay here to meet Ian Knight. Don't tell her I said so, but it's obvious that she's dead soft on Ian. Soft on him? What do you mean? Oh, come on, Jake. Oh, you know, she fancies him. Got a bit of a crush on our Ian Haskay. And I think he's trying to impress her, too. At any rate, I'm off. Mustn't be late for a show. Madame Tussauds. We'll go to the university. Who is that? Oh, okay. That's Nigel's drama teacher, Mr. Tantrum. Mr. Askew rang and asked me about the missing telephone. I think it's simply rotten. People, you can't trust them. They have smiling on honest faces, right? And then they go and do something like this. NSQ said Aaron, Ian, and Gay or Nigel could have taken the phone. Do you know where they are now? Well, Aaron, Ian, and Gay are all actors in the play, so I sent them out to observe people. Aaron is at Parliament. I sent Ian to the Ritz Hotel. Gay went to Covent Garden. There are always some interesting characters there.
Ian is at the Ritz Hotel. Aaron is at the Parliament.
Personally, I don't think any of them took it. Why would they? I think Anna's Q lost it herself and is trying to blame it on someone else. How do you know when an actor like
Anne is telling the truth or when she's acting.
I don't know, Mr. Tantrum, you're the drama teacher.
Well, yes, I suppose you're right. And after all, when are we really being ourselves and when are we acting? If I say, what a gorgeous new coat you have, and I really think it's ugly. And am I acting or is it real life? If I say, your hair looks like someone. Excuse me, Mr. Tantrum, but I'm afraid Stokaze and I have to go. Thanks very much for talking with us.
Shush, Stokaze. Why do some drama people always have to be so dramatic?
But now, we need to figure out how to get to Parliament. Let's check our map of London.
Now?
There's more options. Which direction do we need to go to get from the University of London on Gower Street to the Houses of Parliament near the Westminster Bridge? Check your map of London. Okay, which direction do I need to go from University of... So, Gower Street to Westminster Bridge. Give me a moment, please. Okay, I'm back. It looks like it's either southeast or south. So let's try southeast first. Excuse me. Oh, it's wrong. Then how about south? South? All right. Right, the Houses of Parliament are in the Old Palace of Westminster, right on the bank of the Thames River, south of here. You can almost hear Big Ben from here. Come on, Stokaze, let's go. I'm still trying to fix Jake's voice too, but yeah, me and Guy's voices are a bit. I don't know. I'm not very good at them. Should I have Parliament? I should have known that Aaron would be hanging out with his buddy Felix. Those guys are never apart. Hey Aaron and Felix, did you guys hear? The cellular phone is missing from the old Vic Theatre.
Ooh my, I bet you Aaron sneaked it. He's meant to be a walkie-talkie man.
Ooh yes, that'd be monumentally cool.
Totally Jurassic. To ring your mom from the vid arcade.
On my way home now, mom.
Oh yes, and like to give my drama teacher Mr. Tantrum a ring. Say, afraid I can't make school today, Mr. Tantrum. I'm home, in bed, most deadly ill, flowers drooping on the nightstand.
And actually you're here with me. And actually you're with me, at the cricket ground, watching Derbyshire smash Kent. Oh, you're wicked, mate.
So you'd really like to own a cellular phone, eh, Aaron? When was the last time you saw the one at the theatre?
I used it in the first act. Miss Sullivan, there is trouble in the lab. Come down here immediately. Then I put the phone down and never touch it again.
I don't want a cellular phone, really. If my mate Felix doesn't have one, then it's no good, is it? A phone's only cool if you have someone cool to ring up.
This pair of friends.
I remember them.
Ian Knight is here with Abigail Apru. They're watching the people come and go here in the Ritz Hotel.
Oh, I don't know what voice to give him.
We were just talking about Amy Jelena, the star of stars.
Abigail tells me she stayed here in this very hotel when they were filming Crimson Sails at Elstridge Studios. I'd kill to have the chance to meet her someday and chat. Maybe you should kiss the sidewalk in front of the entrance, Ian. I'm sure she walked on it. Ian is quite bonkers over Amy Juliana. Stuck as he is, I'm sure you and Jake have noticed. Nigel told us a prop is missing from your play. The cellular phone. Ian, can you remember the last time you saw it? Well, of course, I used it in the play. When Dr. Sullivan, that's gay goodbye, makes a great discovery, her hands are shaking so much I have to ring her assistant for her. I go, Eureka, Eureka, the doctor has found a cure. Then, gay kills over date. She's found a cure too late to save herself. It's really quite sad. And then I set the phone down on the table, and it's supposed to stay there until Nigel collects it with the other props. You know, after rehearsal, I saw you telling Gay something, Ian. She sure seemed happy to hear it. What was it all about, eh? Oh, nothing. She just wanted to meet me later, that's all. She said she had a big surprise for me. I said I would. Ian! If I didn't know you better, I think maybe you're getting sweet and gay. Look, you're blushing. I think this is going to be a happy surprise for her.
Wait. She's the one who said she had a surprise for Ian, right? Not the other way around. Madame Tussauds.
Looks like Miss Dunbar and looks like Miss Dunbar is helping Emma Finley with a new costume. It looks great. Emma, did you hear? Your cellular phone is missing down at the Old Vic Theatre. Yes, Jake, I heard. I do hope it will turn up soon. It's not a really expensive phone or anything. But I need to keep it in touch with my friend Amy. Aha. She's a really busy person, so we use the phone to chat whenever she's got a moment. I have her personal phone number stored in the phone. So I just have to touch one button and voila. Voila. I ring right through. Oh, Emma, we can tell Stalker and Jake everything, I think. They are detectives after all. I'm sure they can be trusted. You bet, Miss Dunbar. So what's the big secret? Well, children, my friend Amy is the famous movie star Amy Juliana. We met on the set of her last movie, Crimson Sails, and really hit it off. She's such a smashing person. I love joking with her. Hopefully Emma will be chosen to act with Amy Juliana again in her new movie, Indigo Star. We're putting together a marvelous costume to help her win the audition. Hey, that's really exciting. Did anyone besides you know that your phone contains Amy Juliana's personal telephone number? Is that Juliana or Yulena? Let me check the pronunciation. I'm back. I couldn't find Juliana's pronunciation. For some reason, they keep giving me Joanna. So I'll just stick to Juliana. No, I don't think so. Except Amy did ring me once when I was helping Ye Goodbo up some stairs in the theater. I rang Amy back when we were inside, so Gay is the only one who could know. Why does the voice sound like Jennifer? Hmm. is a bit more difficult. It's a bit more difficult. I feel like there are some very vague things going on here. We're gonna review, okay? Gay Goodbo handles the cellular phone. Is it gay? Alright, she wants to impress Ian. Oh, what did I press? Yeah, I pressed the wrong thing. Okay, I know it now. It's not Ian. I thought it was Ian, but it's Gay Goodbo. She wanted to impress him. So, we'll go for it. Sure. So, Gay Goodbo handles the cellular phone during the second act of the play. Alright. Gay Goodbo has got a big crush on Ian Knight and loves to do things to impress him. Okay. Oh my god, you're gonna ruin it, girl. Gay Goodbo is the only person who could know that the cellular phone could be used to call Amy Juliana directly. I need one which says Ian is a big fan of Yes. Here we go. It's Gay Goodbo. How? Why would you do it? That's called stealing. Oh, I skipped that. Stalkerzy, sometimes people do foolish things in the name of love. Gay Goodbo had a crush on Ian Knight, her co-star in the play Bad Science, so she wanted to do something big to impress him. Indeed. She knew he was totally fascinated by the film star Amy Juliana. So when she saw Emma Finley call up Amy from the cellular phone, she got an idea. After the play, she'd borrow the phone. Oh, borrow, I see. Nobody would see her take it from the table where Ian set it down. Then later, she'd use the phone to let Ian talk to his idol, Amy Juliana. Gay could take it back the next morning and no one would ever know. But Anne and Nigel saw that the phone was missing. We discovered that the only thing special about this phone was one of the private number stored inside it. And only one of the suspects knew how special that phone number was. Gay Goodbo. No, really? Dear Stakaze and Jake, Emma told me how helpful you were in recovering her phone. I can't thank you enough for keeping my secret phone number a secret. If people had learned what that number was, I would get no rest, day or night. Please accept the enclosed back lot passes for L3 Studios. Emma and I hope you can come spend a day with us as we film our new movie, Indigo Star. Bring your camera. Yours very truly, Amy Juliana. And we're done with this episode. That wasn't so bad. I was confused for a while. But I guess I was overthinking it. So, we're done here. And we'll continue the next episode. The next time. Let's see what it's called. Case of the Ancient Armor. Alright, we'll get to this in the next episode. So, thank you for watching. And goodbye.